All right, welcome to my video about Aweber, really the top email autoresponder on the market. Now, I understand what that statement probably does to a few of you. Just let me explain as we get into this video. This has been not the only email autoresponder that I've used, but it is certainly the one that has risen above, far above the rest. And so this video is really intended to educate you, to give you a tutorial, just to show you the setup, and to give you an honest review about Aweber and about what email automation and autoresponding is all about and why it's important to you. There is an URL in the description of this video that you can certainly go to right away and dive in. If need be, nevertheless, sit back and let me show you what we're looking at here. So here is the main homepage of Aweber, and you see how simple it is. I'm telling you, the features that the email autoresponder software that they have is equally as simple, straightforward, yet powerful. Here's what it looks like in the back of so as soon as you've ordered, and you've selected the package that you wish to go with. You can see here. Let me head back here. Let me show you the home screen here. This is pretty powerful. And so I've blurred out a few things for obvious reasons here, but this is the account overview. This is going to allow you to see. You can create as many, just several different lists, all kinds of lists, different websites. If you just have one's fine. This will work for one, but if you've got several, you can scale this out, if you will. And even if you are just one entity, one organization, you can have several different lists, right? You can have lists, a bronze level list, if you will, for just general opt-ins, people that want to be part of your email newsletter. But then you can also create potentially a buyer's list, people that have bought things from you, customers. And so, because if you got those two different groups, right, the kind of marketing message you're sending to those two different groups will be different. So you can segment this and go as deep and as diverse as you want, or you can keep it as simple as you want. But nevertheless, here is your homepage. Here's what you're looking at. Very, very straightforward. Most of you, when you start out, it's going to be empty, right? Because you don't have anything back here. But this is nevertheless what you're going to be able to look at. And to give you that 65,000 foot, 70,000, 90,000, 100,000 foot view of what's going on in your list. And let's remember, an email list is really one of the most valuable assets that you can have. So here's the homepage. And again, you can, let's look at the next option. Here is the follow-up messages. I've created this one earlier as I was going to just show you by example. So I'll just quickly delete that. You can see how quick it is to delete. And so when you get here, and I'll just refresh the screen, it's going to look like this. Okay, so this is where you're going to first create it, your first follow-up message. And you got the drop-down here. Tons of templates to choose from for drag and drop email builder. If I click on that, let's take a look at that so that you can see. Again, this is exactly what you're going to see once you've ordered and gotten yourself an account here at Aweber, should you feel that this video finally has pushed you off the fence, so to speak. So you've got lots of different templates. This template happens to be the plain text template, very similar. You can do HTML if you want, but you got plain text. There's different templates you can click on here just to help you out. Just plenty. I mean, look at this kind of stuff. This is just crazy. This is a new one they happen to have, sort of a Black Friday sale idea. So depending on what you've got going on and what you're the gist of what you want to do. Got all kinds of templates though here, just try and go through this as much. If it's recipe oriented, it's copied over here and you just start filling in the blanks. You can change it up to whatever you want. And just go along here, and this is what's going to be sent out to your customers. And so it looks like you took a lot of time to design. Nevertheless, it's just a very simple template. So we go back up here. You got the follow-up series, and the follow-up series is just automated emails that go out at certain set intervals. So if someone signs up to your list, maybe you want to have something sent out right away. Hey, thanks for subscribing. Then maybe 2 days later, you want to tell them about something else. You want to tell them, lead them along a marketing stretch of emails that go out one after the other after that. Or maybe you just want to, maybe you just want them on the list, and all you're going to do is create what are called broadcast messages, which I'll show you in a bit. In just a second here, follow-up messages though. Again, I'll delete this. I was going to do this as a tutorial earlier, but very straightforward in terms of creating a follow-up email here. Again, I'm going to just, this might seem bland and boring, but this is literally what you're going to get, so it's going to be a little bit different. So it carried over from the message I made before. It carried over into the same design. So you can use that design, or you can, if we go back over here to messages, so leave the page, maybe you just want to do something that's not as fancy as that. You just simply want to do something that's more along the lines of, let's say more of a plain text, okay? So you can come over here, select plain text, and just create a very simple, straightforward, very simple email. So the subject line, you can get very personal here. You can add the depending on what opt-in information you collected when the person opted in. So you can see, you've seen that before. Maybe you're asking for a full name. Maybe you're just asking for a first name. Maybe you're only asking for an email. If you ask for that first name, you can say get real personal with people. So the subject line is hello. And if their first name happened to be Kathy, it would say hello, Kathy, in the subject line. You can carry on with that personalization right down in the message itself, again with Kathy's first name. It will not show all these weird characters. It will show whatever first name she's put in there. And so then you can carry on with whatever you want to write. You click save, and I might as well show you what that says. You got the drafts down here, so if you ever are going along making certain adjustments and something happens, and maybe you want to go back to your 1:16 p.m. draft version, you can go back by clicking load. So very, very simple. You click next, gives you the option to track the clicks on the on website links in your message so that you know what people are clicking on, what aren't they. Maybe you want to test certain things out. Very, very versatile. You can save and exit here, and that first follow-up message has been created. So let's, you know, I don't want to get into too much detail here. It's pretty straightforward, but there it is. And so what you can do with this, you can see that obviously it's going to be sent immediately, but you know, every other follow-up message after that, it will ask you, do you want to send it out right after this one? Do you want to send it out a day later, two, three, four? You decide. It's up to you what those intervals are going to look like as you keep creating emails and they keep getting listed here as your follow-up email list. Here are broadcasts. Broadcasts are like, let's say you have 1,000 subscribers and you just, you know, it's a Black Friday and you just want to send out this super sale you've come up with. You can send out a broadcast message to all your list. It's a one-time thing. Just send it out, blast it out, real simple. It's not going to be part of the follow-up series. It's completely separate, and you can do that here. And again, the interface is completely simple yet very powerful, because you can add in the personalization, you can add in the templates and all that sort of stuff. So really, really, really powerful, very robust email autoresponder. That's why I like it, and that's why I've used it and continue to use it for all of my thousands and thousands of subscribers that I've got. So and that's of course across several different lists. And so but here we can look at the subscribers, and a lot of information can get here. You can dig and do a real deep dive into who subscribed to your list, who was added today, yesterday, 7 days, 30 days, who's active, who's unsubscribed, all kinds of stuff here. You can get very particular, look for a specific field. I'm just looking for people named Kathy. Let's just roll with the name Kathy in this video example. And you can search for that and find it out, sort it out as well. So you can dig and dig deep in terms of finding out who you're or finding that subscriber or a certain group of subscribers that you are looking for. You can add subscribers. So let's say you already have subscribers. You have the ability to add them manually. You can import more than 10. Very powerful, even if perhaps you have had another solution and you're switching over. There's ways to do it. There's ways to get those other lists into Aweber. So at least you're not stuck having to start completely from scratch. Now you got sign up forms. Of course, these are the forms that you want to put on your website. You can see some samples here. Very straightforward. These are look like sidebar. I guess they could also be in the center of the page as well. But let's take a look at what happens when you create your first sign up form. And so here we go. You got lots of templates to choose from. So let's say we take this one. Well, let's just scroll along, see what we got. Let's go with this one. Let's load this one up. So you can play around with it. You can change how wide you want it. You can make it, you can change the pics. You can make it, a popover, you can make it a light box, you can make it a pop-up, all different types. Very, very simple. Depending on what you're looking for, if you know a pop, you know, obviously it's inline, it's on the site itself. If it's a popover, it explains what it is, hovers within the web page, usually unblockable. Then you got a light box. It's identical to a popover, but it darkens your entire page and really focuses the visitor on this sign up form. And hopefully the copy that you have on that form really drives them to convert into an email opt-in, because as you know, the money is in the list, as they say. So having a list of subscribers is super, super important. And then of course a pop-up opens in a new window, and it is blocked by most browsers. Nevertheless, they do give you the option there. That's why I'm saying Aweber is just so robust in what it offers. It'll give you even what may not work as well. But if you want to do it, you've got the option. So I'd much rather have the option than not have the option at all. And so again, we can go into just changing all kinds of stuff up in terms of what we can see here. We can change the image. If you want to have a different image down here, you can get rid of this one. You can add a new one, center it, and all that kind of stuff. So very, very powerful and very, very simple yet at the same time. So then you can go over here to reports. And reports allow you to take a look at all kinds of reports here on the left-hand side, just an entourage of what do you need to find out. You can find it here. And then, of course, it's reflected right here with, and why don't we take a look at that? Let me switch over to maybe a slightly more popular list that I have. And let's see what that looks like when you've got some graphs. So you got some graphs here, not bad. Shows you, you know, how many subscribed and some unsubscribed here. Something with a little bit more life, of course. But depending on what you want to do, you can get as detailed as you want about what you're looking for. This seems like this particular list is just an example, but you can see there's just as many subscriptions as there's unsubscriptions as it goes along here. So, but nevertheless, hey, there you go. Let's look at, you can also set up scheduled reports as well if this is something you want to make sure you get, right? You can look right here, every week, or every day, every week, every 2 weeks, every month, you can have that just put together and emailed out to you. So that way you've got it on file and you can go over it and just monitor how your email autoresponder is doing. List settings, custom fields, list automation. So we go to list settings here. This allows you to see, and again, I'm blurring this out here, but you can see, you know, the list name, list description, who do you want the emails, the autoresponder emails to come from, the broadcast emails to come from. Also notifications, you can have an email and a name entered in here so you can be notified if you want of how, you know, every time someone subscribes. And so that can be powerful too, to see those emails coming in saying, hey, you got a new subscriber. List automation, take a look at this one. You can create a new rule, so that says something like unsubscribe from this list when subscribing to, you know, this list. Unsubscribe from this list when unsubscribing from this list. Subscribe to this list when subscribing to. So there's some, you know, you might go, I don't need that. That's fine. But those of you that are seeing what I'm seeing here, this is very, very powerful when you start to get into segmenting your lists. So that, because there's a big difference between someone who's general, you know, sort of generally opted in, and then that person that is opted in as a buyer to some degree. So again, that'll be up to you how you want to use it. But I hope that this email has, or pardon me, this video has, is shown you what email marketing can do, email autoresponder software. From Aweber is, of course, like I said, one of the best. I hope that I've kind of, you know, pushed you off the fence, at least in one direction or another. There's nothing worse than kind of being stuck in the middle. But I hope you'd, you know, join all of us here at Aweber as customers. I haven't had a problem and haven't had an issue with them. And again, I just want to thank you for watching.